Well, good morning. Oh, you have announcements, don't you? LOL. Go ahead, John Michael. Okay, so sorry, John Michael. All right, everybody, we are so excited to worship with you this morning. If you want to stand, if you're able, we're going to have a big old praise party and welcome the Lord into this place. Let's sing.
All the light with the truth.
Hear the sound.
Hear the sound. Let the Lord of heaven begin.
So awesome to be here today. The Bible talks a lot about praising him in the storm. And today is probably one of the hardest days of the year for me. And 31 years ago, I lost my brother to suicide. Thank you.
ultimate one that we can run to, Lord. We're so grateful that even in our sin, in our humanity, that you pursue us, Lord, that we have the ability to pursue you. Thank you for your grace and your mercy in those times when we do fall short, in those times when we just can't understand your great love for us. Thank you that you speak it over and over and over. You sing over us, Lord. Thank you so much. We love you. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. At this time, I would like to invite Dustin DeVries up to share his testimony with us. So if you want to take a seat, feel free.
James 1, 2 through 4 says this, "Consider it pure joy, my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds, because you know that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. Perseverance must finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything." I just wanted to take some time this morning to encourage you guys with some stuff that has been really encouraging to me throughout the last couple months. So when I'm thinking of this verse, the thing I think of the biggest thing that kept me going over the years when I was faced with difficulties and challenges and all the unknowns that we encounter in life was believing that regardless of what was going on and regardless of the outcome, God had a plan for me, a purpose for me, and would see me through. Jeremiah 29:11 was the first thing that I thought of when I was thinking about this, and it says that he gives us a future, and it's supposed to help us prosper, to be fulfilling. It's not supposed to harm us or be destroying to us. And Philippians 1:6 says that he who began a work in you will see it through. The tough times that we face are not meant to destroy us. They're meant to deliver us. I think God allows challenging times to beat us up sometimes. Just like Job, he lost everything. But God still used that. He used that season in our lives to refine us, to grow us, to strengthen us, and develop us. Nothing that you go through is a waste. I like the song by Elevation Worship that is called Never Lost. And it talks about how God has battles that he fights for us, and he never loses those battles. Nothing is a waste. God knows that you can't make it on your own, but he knows that he can help you get through. Your strength comes from God. And for that, I just want to highlight growth. The thing about growth is that it doesn't happen without intentional and consistent hard work. God wants to grow in a personal relationship with you, but that requires being intentional. God is intentional with us, but are we intentional with him? It's something that is honestly very hard to be consistent with, especially in our world today. You might not know what your purpose is right now, and you might feel like God isn't leading you, but I promise you that he is leading and guiding you in some way if there is proof that you're not giving up. They say that simply showing up is half the battle. Just putting forth that effort to show up and give it another go. Trouble's going to come. The Bible tells us to take heart, to choose to be courageous. Tharseo in the Greek, it's active and present. So choose to take heart. Choose to be courageous despite what's going on around you. John 16:33 highlights this and says to take heart. Perfect peace is given to us. Peace when we choose to trust God no matter what, even if doing just that doesn't make any sense. And I believe that sometimes God leaves out all the details because he knows that if we knew all the details, we wouldn't go. We wouldn't follow him. So he leaves part of it out because he knows that following after him is the best thing for us. I love this quote from Tim Tebow. It says this, "I can trust an unknown future to a known God." Let that sink in for a second. That's crazy. John 16:34 says that he has overcome the world. So keep pushing on. I always like to say, head up and eyes forward. And you're here at GCU for a specific reason, for a specific purpose. When I was here as a freshman, I had no clue why I was here other than to play soccer. And that's fine, for a season. But then over time, God began to reveal to me other reasons why I was here and gave me more opportunities to get involved, to be ministered to be invested in, and to then serve and lead and invest in others. And understanding this process, it takes time. And for you, God has a specific plan in mind just for you, a job that only you can do. So despite the difficulties, the challenges, and all the confusion that continues to stare you in the face, keep on believing that God's got something going on behind the scenes. And remember Philippians 3:14, not looking back, but straining toward what lies ahead. We look back to learn, we will look forward to grow. So never give up. Embrace the journey, embrace the grind, and press on. So I want to close with this. We press on because God is going to see us through. The Bible says that God never breaks his promises. Let me say that again. God never breaks his promises. Never. Life is tough. Adversity will come. But one thing that we'll never do in life is walk alone. God is walking with you every single step of the way. And the battles that you face, they were not meant to destroy you. They were meant to deliver you. I hope that encourages you guys this morning. That's been a huge encouragement to me. Just in the little bit that's going on in the world around us. So take heart. Choose to be courageous. Don't give up on God because he's not going to give up on you. Continue to trust him. Trust the plan even though you probably might not see all the details. Nothing might make sense, but there's purpose in that.
So we want to introduce a new song to you guys this morning from Elevation Worship, and it's called Available, and it's based on Proverbs 3, verses 5 and 6. So I want to read that to you real quick. And that verse says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your paths straight." And really, this song has a powerful message of submission to say, Lord, whatever you want to do in my life, whatever you want to do through me, I am available for that. And like Dustin said, we might not always get the full picture. We might not always know exactly where we're going or exactly how it's all going to work out. But we know that we need to be available, that we need to say, Lord, where you are, there I will go. So please join us in singing this next song. for the one who gave me life. Nothing is a sacrifice. Use me how you want to, God. Have your throne within my heart.
Just take the spirit of that song with us as we go to our break. But we have one more song that Dustin actually mentioned in his testimony, Never Lost. And I pray that we can just declare this morning as a victory song, that the Lord is fighting for us. The Lord is on our side. He's never lost a battle, and he never will. So I don't know what your break looks like, whether you're going back to a dysfunctional household, or if you're going to Florida, or whatever it looks like, the Lord is with you. I hope that you know that. The Lord is with you, and he fights for you. He fights for his kids, and he loves you. So let's sing this in victory.
lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. And I know, you never will. And you can do all things. Oh, we believe that you can do all things but fail. 'Cause you never lost a battle. No, you never lost a battle. And I know, you never will.
Do you believe it?
And I know, you never will. And I know, you never will.
Yes, Lord. Amen. Amen. Let me just pray as we send you out for your break. Father God, thank you so much for being the one who goes before us, who fights our battles. We trust you. We love you so much. Please give us a safe break, that it would be fruitful and glorifying to you, that we would rest and come back refreshed for the rest of the semester. We love you so much. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Have a great spring break, everybody.